Okay, The Flash, episode 6, The Flash is Born. Honestly, the most interesting part for me was Joe looking into, you know, Barry's mother's death. And again, Iris with, you know, creating the Flash, or at least his name. But other than that, the rest of the episodes just seemed kind of questionable. Because it seemed like a PSA, an answer to how you should handle bullying. While at the same time mixing it in with superheroes and taking on the supervillain. But either way, you know, that story has been done to death, and sometimes, you know, it's not done right, or even then, it's just, you know, not even performed. They don't have an answer. They just, like, different opinions mashed together, and it just comes off as weird and wrong to a certain extent. But either way, of course, they're continuing the plot line of Iris writing the blog and Flash convincing her to stop. And again, this whole tension between Barry and Iris, it just sounds kind of like, oh, come on, you know, just tell her, as the Flash, tell her, you know, there are other metahumans out there, they're gonna come after me, they'll come after you. And finally, that's kind of revealed, because this new metahuman actually shares a connection to Iris and Barry from their childhood. So now she's figured out, like, okay, so there are other people out there with powers, and that's gonna bring them to me, to, you know, so that I can bring them to the Flash. But still, she's still, you know, stubborn as hell. She's still writing that blog. And I always questioned why a lot of people, when they see a character like this, especially a female character, is saying, yeah, you go, girl. It's like, she takes no shit. It's like, she's gonna get killed. It's like, yeah, you go, girl. Oh, shit, she just died. Well, she died making all other females proud. Like, what's the point if you're gonna get yourself killed? I mean, really? I guess you can be a martyr of some sorts, but really, is that the only way to make a change? Be a martyr? Like, no, there are different ways of doing so while keeping yourself safe at the same time. But, you know, whatever. You know, a very outspoken voice is stronger than a silent voice. I'm just saying. But either way, you know, she's still writing the blog, you know, she comes up with the name The Flash, and ultimately that's the one part about this whole plot story that I do like, you know, that she creates The Flash, or at least his name. So either way, with Joe, you know, he's looking to Wells as to, you know, he might be a suspect. He's, you know, he's suspicious, like, you moved, you know, to Central City kind of the same time that Barry's mother died. So of course you have to be, I have to question you. Also, you know, you had all these inventions and he had these ideas. Who's to say you don't already have a particle accelerator already? One that went wrong and gave you powers, right? And that's a good assumption. Joe makes a good assumption. I like that. And even I was thinking, like, yeah, Wells could be the one, who knows? But it's revealed that he lost his wife or his partner. It wasn't really made clear. But, you know, they came up with a plan for the particle accelerator, but they never accomplished it. She died. So he came to Central City to move away from, you know, their research lab and continue the, you know, their project. So, of course, you know, he never had the particle accelerator before. But again, I'm thinking, you know, super speed. With enough speed, you can actually, you know, go back in time or, you know, rip through the fabric of time. But again, I don't know, maybe that's it. But either way, again, you know, as soon as Joe is kind of convinced that, okay, Wells isn't the one, as soon as he crosses Wells' name, like, yeah, he's not a suspect, the yellow, you know, Flash just comes in and starts making a whirlwind similar to, you know, when Barry's mother died. And of course, you know, Joe is scared, like, shit, you know, I didn't think, you know, he'd come after me. Like, of course he is. You're trying to find the guy, you know, who killed Barry's mom. Of course he's going to come after you. And even, you know, saw a picture of Iris, you know, stabbed with a knife saying, stop, you know, looking into this or I'll kill her. And of course you can actually see the fear in Joe's eyes. And I did like that. Like, wow, this is heavy. It's like, not only is Joe realizing, you know, how dangerous researching something like this is, you know, but he's also realizing how many people around him can get hurt. It's not his life that's in danger, you know? And again, it brings me back to Iris. As soon as she realizes that this isn't going to affect her, it's going to affect everyone around her, father, her boyfriend, even maybe even Barry or anyone else around her. You know, some metahumans might go after them. And again, she doesn't realize that. So it just shows that how young and naive Iris is and idealistic, while Joe is more realistic. It's like, yeah, I kind of want to live an ideal world where, you know, I just focus my time on the crime, I'll figure it out and find the, you know, the culprit. But doing so can also put, you know, not just my life in danger. It can put a lot of people's lives in danger if I'm not careful. But either way, hopefully Joe kind of puts two and two together, because as soon as he crosses Wells' name off, the yellow flash comes in. Yeah, that's kind of, you know, suspicious. I have to keep looking into Wells without him knowing. But either way, you know, maybe he won't research. He's just worried about Iris's life, and that's why. Who knows? Maybe Barry will eventually get mad at Joe for giving up so soon, or something to that fashion. I have no idea. But either way, to the supervillain of this episode, how can I say this? He's kind of stereotypical. I mean, what I mean is, apparently his connection to Iris and Barry is back in, I'm going to say, grade school. He was the bully of the school, and he picked on, you know, Barry, and he was the jock, I suppose. And that's pretty much it. Now he has superpowers, but he's still just kind of, he's drinking alcohol, he's working now, he's like, oh, I'm awesome. You know, he works as a construction worker. But it's, again, nothing against construction work. That's very difficult, I understand. But it's so stereotypical. And you know, I'm just saying, it's like, I've seen this character before. Why is he here? And again, the only connection he has to them is he was their bully. I don't know. And even throughout the episode, they were kind of giving mixed messages as how to deal with bullies. Like, some fights you should run away from. Some fights you just have to, you know, punch once. You just have to punch in the right, you know, spot or something like that. You have to stand and fight, and, you know, stand your ground. And just like, wait, which one are you trying to pass off? And it just seems kind of like, yeah. I mean, I was bullied as a kid, and I never got any of these messages. I didn't run from the fight, you know, but I still stood my ground. I took both of my bullies on, two of them, and they were both bigger than me, both, you know, bigger and bigger. You know, like, so really, I just stood my ground and did my best to take them down, you know. But I didn't just do it to make them afraid of me. I didn't do it just to make them stop picking on me. I did it so I can make them realize that by doing what they're doing, they're eventually going to find or run into someone that's going to fight back. And they might not always fight back, you know, fair, with fist to fist. They might pull a knife. They might pull a gun out of self-defense. I have no idea. And I ended up talking with these two, and I found out that they didn't really have good lives. Like, you know, they were neglected to a certain extent. You know, so we just started talking, and we ended up actually very good friends. So I'm not saying to fight back your bully just for fighting alone. I'm saying stand up to them and try to figure out why they are that way. And in this one, it just seems like the bully is just a bully to be a bully. To make the point, you have to beat up your bully to a certain, to, you know, a certain point. Not like kicking them when they're down. No, just punch them once hard enough and they'll go down and that's it. It's like, I don't know. I really don't know. But either way, like I said, you know, the supervillain of this episode wasn't that fun. Wasn't that interesting. He's cliche, stereotype. It was just a mess. It really, even the message was kind of muddled. They didn't really know what they were going for. But yeah. Either way, like I said, really it was just Joe and Iris who were the main points for me. And other than that, yeah, this episode wasn't as fun, exciting as it should have been, but who knows. Either way, hopefully the next episode is much better supervillain at least. Until then, I'm Tony Dragon, bye-bye.